In this screencast, we will discuss the differences between interacting and non-interacting processes. Recall, in a process from a control standpoint, what we're interested in finding is how an input X influences an output Y. However, the relationship between the input variable X and the output variable Y may not be direct. In other words, it may not happen with just one material or one energy balance. In fact, there could be a number of intermediate variables which allows for a relationship between the input X and the output Y. For a non-interacting system, the input is directly related to an intermediate variable, which can be related to one or more other intermediate variables in perfect succession until it reaches the output variable Y. This is generally seen for systems in pure series. For an interacting system, what happens here is the fact that although there are intermediate variables present, what's happening is the fact that there is some variable on the left or in the beginning is a function of a variable that comes afterwards. So for example, if the variable B were a function of A, that would indicate an interaction between all of the variables. The two most common ways that we see interacting variables are for recycle streams or systems where recycling is occurring, a common occurrence in chemical engineering processes, and for the sake of a controls course, any feedback control scheme has some interaction because you are using the variable at the very end, the measurement of the controlled variable. You're using that variable in the beginning to conduct analysis because you're trying to find the error between that value and the set point. To show an example of interacting and non-interacting systems, we're going to look at some tanks in series. We'll develop a model of three tanks in series. The transfer function we're interested in is how the exiting temperature, T3, is going to be influenced by a change in the inlet temperature, T0. So therefore, the transfer function of interest here is T3 over T0. Obviously, the temperature of T3 is not immediately related to T0. The temperature of T3 will be based on the temperature that comes out of the second tank, T2. If we assume the fact the tank is well mixed, then the temperature of the fluid exiting the tank will be the same as the fluid tank temperature. However, T2, the new input variable, is also not related to the inlet temperature. We can get those connected by the temperature exiting the first tank. And again, if we assume a well-mixed tank, the exiting temperature coming out of tank 2 will also be equal to the temperature of the fluid in the second tank. We can finally connect that value to the input T0 via the first tank, where similarly we have the fact that the outlet of the first tank is equal to the fluid temperature inside the first tank. So what we see here is that by changing T0, which if we look at our above case would be X, we have changed what the temperature inside the first tank will be. That will change what's going on coming out of the first tank, which will be T1, variable A, which will then affect the second tank and the outlet temperature T2, which will then affect the temperature T3. But note, this goes in a direct fashion. T0 influences T1, which influences T2, which influences T3. For an example of interacting, we can take a look at the same non-interacting system that we just developed. However, by making one modification to our diagram here, we can change the system from being non-interacting to interacting. As an example, and to be consistent with what we discussed for interacting processes above, what could happen is the fact that the fluid in the second tank could be recycled back to the first tank. So what this means is that the inlet temperature T0 affects T1, but T1 is influenced not only by just T0, but it is also influenced by the change in the temperature in the second tank, which in turn is influenced by the temperature coming out of the first tank, hence the interaction. So therefore, this provides an example of an interacting system. In controlled processes, we will always deal with interacting processes. And as you would probably hazard a guess, the mathematical analysis of these equations is a little more challenging because of the more coupling nature, the interacting nature between these. So hopefully through this screencast you have seen and appreciated the difference between interacting and non-interacting systems.